Hello everybody, my name is Leo and with this video we will share a demo review of the MESA Boogie Long Star, which is an amp I wanted so badly for many years, and is also actually the amp used by one of my favorite guitarists, that is Andy Timmons. As always, we will start with a demo song, then we will briefly describe the main characteristics of the amp before describing in detail the functionalities, the knobs and so on. We will then hear more clearly the amp sounds in the indicated section of this video, and finally I will give you, as usually, my 2 cents. So I hope you enjoy, and please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell, it will be of a great help. Let's start with the demo song. Now let me give you a brief description of the amp before going into the details. The Long Star is a 2-channel amp where channel 1, the upper one, produces clean sounds with low to medium gain ranges. This channel can also be driven to clip and accept very well pedals. On the other hand, channel 2 can either be set to achieve a slightly gainer clone of channel 1 or can become a high gain preamp. The amp has 5 12 AX7 valves and 4 power valves that can be either 6L6 or 4EL34, and allows us to choose between 3 different wattage ratings across 2 different classes of operations. We can select 50 or 100 watts of class AB, wiring push-pull, or switch down to 10 watts of pure class A in a single-ended configuration for more harmonic content. It has serial effects loop with send control and is possible to hard bypass the effect loop. It has a built-in reverb and a foot switch for channel switching. Now let's describe the amp in details. Let's start from left to right. First of all, we have the guitar input, and then we have an input for an external foot switch provided with the amp, with which you can change the channel or activate the solo function that we will see later on. Then we have the drive knob. This is the pre-drive control for the high gain preamp in channel 2. It can be removed from the circuit using the switch highlighted with a red circle. Basically, when it is switched on, it activates another tube gain stage. Then we have the gain knobs that adjust the predominant gain stage in each channel. Obviously in channel 2 it works together with the drive knob. Then we have a 3-position mini toggle that allows manual selection of the channel when the foot switch is not connected. It should be set in the center in order to use the foot switch to select the channels. Then we have the tick normal ticker 3-position mini toggle that allows you to select between 3 different voicings. selecting what frequency the treble control will announce. Normal would be the best choice for traditional blackface style clean or clipped sound. Thick lowers the frequency of the treble region while keeping the gain closer to that of the normal setting. You might think of it as the plexi switch, as it is the best choice when searching for classic style response for either chording or overdriven sound. Thicker lowers the treble frequency even further and adds considerable gain in that region. Then we have the treble, mid and bass knobs for each channel. As in the most tube guitar amplifiers, the treble control is the most powerful of the rotary controls and is next in line only to the gain control as a shaping tool. The presence control is a high frequency attenuator that is placed at the end of each channel preamp stage and affects frequencies higher than those of the treble control. It acts independently of the other rotary tone controls and it is crucial in voicing the channel. Lower presence control settings darken and compress the signal, which works well to fatten single note solo sounds. Then we have the master volumes for each channel that is placed before the effect loop and with which you can adjust the volume independently for each channel. And then we have the output volume knob with which you adjust the overall volume of the amp and is placed after the effect loop. The solo knob works in conjunction with the foot switch. Basically, when you activate it with the foot switch, you can raise the volume, for instance, in the case you are soloing. Then we have a toggle for each channel in order to select the output wattage and style of power of each channel independently.
In the 100 or 50 watt
settings, two or one pair of tubes are online, delivering maximum power and punch from a circuit operating in class AB, wired in a push-pull configuration. The 10 watt setting causes a complete reconfiguration of our power section. Here we are in pure class A, which is far less efficient, producing more heat and less power, but with sweeter, warmer sounding clip characteristics that never sound edgy or harsh. Then we have a sideways three-position toggle switch that determines the status of the incoming AC power. The Lone Star incorporates a built-in variac feature that enables us to reduce the line voltage. In tweet position, we obtain a spongier, scoopier response and allows us to power clip the amplifier at lower overall volume. Another bonus is that if you are in the tweet power setting, tube life will increase substantially. Then in the back panel, first of all, we have the silicon or tube rectifier toggle switch. Selecting diodes chooses the solid state diode rectifiers, which deliver maximum power and headroom while tracking tighter and imparting a quicker transient response and bolder attack. Tube rectifier tracking engages the 5U4 rectifier tube for Saki Brown old school power clip. Then we have the FX loop section with the send level, then in and output jack and the bypass toggle switch, with which basically you hard bypass the FX loop. Then we have two knobs to control the reverb amount for each channel. With a specific toggle you can switch between two types of reverb: reverb light, that is similar to a spring reverb, and reverb warm, that is similar to a plate reverb. Then we have two jacks that provide an interface for remote control of the channel select function as well as activation of the solo control. These jacks may be connected to an external control unit that store a grounding logic suite function under a MIDI program number, thereby removing the need to use the included Lone Star foot switch. Then the last thing I would mention as regards the back panel is the bias select, by which you can choose EL34 power valves or 6L6.
Thank you.
Now, final considerations here. Well, first of all, typically there are amps that I like for their clean sound and others for their overdriven tones. Actually, with this amp, I love them both. The clean tones are really balanced, they cut through the mix without being too intrusive, and there is the right amount of high frequencies without being too harsh or too sparkly, but really pleasing my ear. The overdriven tones are warm, and what impressed me the most is the articulation. I mean, how the amp really invites you to balance your touch, to use your pick to express different nuances of the notes according to the emotion you want to express. The attack of your notes is so nice, and the amp really invites you to experiment with the pick position, the force you put in each note, and so on and so forth. Actually, as I always say, the gear you use should inspire you. And this amp inspires me, the demo song, that is pretty, I would say, intimate. Because I think that the amp is really emotional, intimate and warm. You know, when I switch on my Plexi or my JCM 800, they really inspire me to write hard rock riff with their amazing and ferocious distorted tones. While this Mesa is, well, it's a lone star, it's far in the sky, it's alone, and it is asking you to play with respect, calibrating every note. So this is the end of this video. Please let me know in the comment below what's your opinion about this amp, and which is the amp that is more emotional and warm for you. And please don't forget to subscribe, to hit the notification bell and leave a thumbs up. It would be of great help. And of course, you won't miss my future videos. In fact, I have a lot of new content I would like to share with you, like for instance, which amp modeling pedalboard sound more close to the Lone Star, between, for instance, the HX Helix or the Head Rush or the Moor. If you're interested in my music, you can check out the playlist of songs of mine in the description below, where there is also a link to the streaming services distributor that I use, that is DistroKid. If you use that link, you will have a discount and I will earn some money. So, you're gonna actually help the channel. Thank you in advance. This is the end. See you in the next video. Bye bye.